Mother's Day to all of you women who have poured time, energy, and love into the children that God has brought into your lives. Thank you for the difference that you have made in our world by your kind words, actions, and prayers. I'm going to open with a word of prayer this morning if you'll join me. God, thank you for this opportunity to be together. God, to celebrate the women that you have placed into our lives. The moms, the grandmas, the aunts, the adopted parents, the kind women from the church that are always there when you need a helping hand or a kind word or a prayer, God. I thank you for putting these women into our lives at just the right times to encourage us and to help us. Sometimes we don't even realize that they're praying for us, God, but that they are, and that they are. Their love just overflows, God, because you have placed it in them. And I thank you for each one of the ladies here and the difference that they've made in my life, my children's lives, and in the lives of all of the younger generations that have come after them. Thank you for this day that we can be together, that we can be in your house, and we can worship you. Please watch over us. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Please stand as we sing God So Loved.
Forever defeated. We are glad you are guys are here with us to worship today. Just some things to kind of keenly keep you aware of in the life of church that's going on. We have two more Bible study sessions before we kind of shut down for the summer. So, and we're studying the book of John. And so it was really good this last week. So we studied John chapter 2. I learned a bunch of things this last week, so it was pretty exciting for me as well. Things that I hadn't really kind of looked into. So it was good. And so we meet Thursdays at 6:30. And then again, the parade float, we're gearing up for that. And we're getting excited about that. And there are several ways that you can help in our bulletin. And so if you want to look at that, you can figure out a way to do that. And then next Sunday is our graduation Sunday for our graduates. We have three of them from here this year. And we are excited to celebrate them. Two from high school and one from college. So you can see that there. And one of them is here this morning. So we're super excited about that. So. And then the list of Little Rockies church camp dates are in there for the different weeks and the different age groups, so you can see that as well. And then the last thing I have is there's a couple things going on today. We want you to be aware that we love babies, okay? And we want you to know that we support this organization called Echoes Pregnancy Center in Great Falls. Again, it is a direct competition to the Planned Parenthood, the government-funded facility in Great Falls called Planned Parenthood. We'll just call it that, okay? They come from a biblical perspective, and they do all of their funding through gifts of generosity from churches, from people, from different things that go on. And if you want to help, they do this baby bottle campaign yearly from Mother's Day to Father's Day. And you can see up here that we have baby bottles. And you can fill one with your spare change. You can fill one with dollars. You can fill them with checks. You can fill them with $100 bills. You can fill them with whatever you want to fill them with in a monetary sense to help them. And here's on the back of this flyer, it tells you what your money goes to, what they directly go to, okay? $10 will pay for two new Bibles, $25 pays for five pregnancy tests, $50 provides parenting classes, and $115 provides a life-revealing ultrasound exam. So You can see what that goes towards. And so we want everyone to know that we love babies, and so we want them to be in this world. And so we help them through that. And so if you want to be a part of that, grab a baby bottle on your way out. Have it returned by Father's Day. And that way, Father's Day is June 18th, I think. Is that correct? Okay, good. I don't know if that's correct or not, but anyway, so that's what you want to do. That and when you return them, please just bring them up here and put them on stage, or you can put them in the office if you know where that's at. So that is something fantastic that I love that we're a part of. And the second thing is Mother's Day. We love moms too. Okay, and we want to give you a token of appreciation. So we ask the Dutch Mutt to make their special cookies. So there are cookies up here for you moms. Men, keep your hands off. They're for moms. All right? So grab a cookie on your way out. Grab two on your way out. We sure would love for you to celebrate mom and, you know, celebrate your day today. And we want you to know that we love you and that we appreciate you. And they're actually in the shape of flowers. So this is a flower you can eat. I mean, you can eat other flowers and make soups out of them, but I mean, this is going to be way better, I promise, okay? I promise. I've sampled far too many of Dutch Mutt's treats, okay? So they are all fantastic. So they make a Dutch Mutt. I'm just Christy. She's the Dutch Mutt, if anybody doesn't tell. She makes a carrot cake.
Yeah.
I hate carrot cake.
Church.
I hate carrot cake. Okay?
Oh, it's the best.
But she made me try her carrot cake one day, okay? And it was like blew my doors off, okay? Like I was like, okay, I eat your carrot cake. That's it. So I can attest to the fact that these cookies are going to be fantastic. Everything that she has made has ever been fantastic. So please, moms, ladies, women, I'll explain in a moment, but every woman is welcome to having cookies, okay? So please partake in that, okay? But anyway, we want to say thank you to Dutch Mutt for all the big help that you come through for us, okay? Is there any other events or things coming up that I want to talk about out there? Okay, let me pray. God, I just come to you to thank you so much for this day. Thank you for the chance that we have to come together and celebrate as family. Lord, and today is a special day, and we get to celebrate those women and the moms in our lives that have cared and nurtured us and loved us through a lot of pain and misery on their end, Lord, sometimes. But, Lord, we just say thank you for them. We thank you that you provided that your nature in their lives, and that you've been able to help us guys survive through some things, Lord. And so we just thank you for that. Lord, we are so grateful for the things that you give us in our lives, the provisions you provide for us in every way that we need. And so, Lord, we thank you for that. But the biggest way, Lord, that we want to say thank you is that you provided a way to you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, the death, burial, resurrection at the cross is something that we do not neglect, that we do not take for granted. And so, Father, we just want to say thank you for that. And always remember that is the reason that we worship. That is the reason that we live. That is the reason that we come together as family to worship, Lord. And so we say thank you. It's in your precious Son's holy name that we do pray. Amen.
If you feel comfortable standing, please stand as we continue in our song service.
There were walls between.
I'm a good man, so I
things I forgot to mention during our announcement time is, hey, who let the dogs out, right? No worries. No big deal.
No big deal.
I forgot to mention, next week is graduation Sunday, right? But we have a breakfast to honor our graduates. I forgot to mention that. So there is no Sunday school that day. Breakfast is at 10 o'clock. All of you are welcome to come and join in that celebration as well. And I know that there's a couple slots left to kind of donate food. If you wanted to sign up for that, we sure would love to you to do that as well. And then I wrote it down on the back, but I forgot to flip over the paper. On May 28th, Memorial Day weekend, there's going to be a cookout at the Biles at 4 p.m. It's going to be a barbecue potluck. It's kind of a going away celebration for the Dunns. So we wanted to invite everybody out to that, out at their house. If you've never been out there, you go towards Geraldine. They're about 13 miles, so they're on the right-hand side. So, but we wanted to invite you to that as well. And again, it's a barbecue potluck, okay? So don't expect there to be just all the food there, so you got to bring something to share, okay? Those are a couple things I forgot to mention. All right. On the backs of your bulletins is our prayer and praise. So if you want to see that and give us any updates or any encouraging praises, we sure would love for you to do that now, or if we can be praying for you today. So how is that? Yes, ma'am.
I'm just thankful for the children that God entrusted me to raise.
She's thankful for the children that God gave her and entrusted to her. So, very good. Anything else? Yep.
I am very thankful. I left my country and I left my mom and my grandma at home. But then I came down here and I got a mother-in-law. Oh, no. A mother-in-law, a grandmother that are now my mom and my grandma. And then I have had all of you ladies that have helped to raise me up and to help me to be a good mom to my kids. And I'm just so thankful for all of you. I mean, even ones that are closer in my age, you guys have helped to guide me to be a good mom. And I'm just so thankful. And I know I'm not a young mom anymore, but I'm still a younger mom in the church. And I appreciate all the time that you ladies have poured into my life and my family's life. So thank you.
Absolutely. She is thankful for, as we all are, for moms. And she came down here from Canada, and so she's thankful for all of you that have helped her along the way. So anything else? Yes, sir.
Grateful for the music that was chosen this morning. Thankful for the worship this morning.
Absolutely. Terry is thankful for the talented ladies up here that give us their blessings. So we sure do appreciate that. So, anything else? Yes, ma'am.
I'm thankful that we meet in Zach with Elizabeth.
Right. We are. If you hadn't heard, I'm not going to share all of it. If you hadn't heard, she was having some problems with the house that was kind of causing some of her health problems, it seems like. So we're getting that straightened out. They're getting that straightened out for her. And she's feeling a lot better today, right?
Yes.
Yeah, she's getting there. So we are thankful for that as well. We're so glad that everybody kind of discovered it. So, absolutely. Keep praying for one of you, those who health is on the mend. So we are glad for that. Anything else? Sure.
I'm thankful to be able to go to church with these two matriarch Hankins ladies, the last of their generation, and to celebrate Mother's Day. Because they are the ultimate mothers.
Right.
I second that.
Cheryl is thankful for Betty and Barb as the matriarchs of the Hankins family. So we are thankful that they have had such a good impact on all the people that they've come in contact with throughout the years. So yeah, we are definitely thankful too. Anything else? Yes, ma'am.
I'm thankful for the kids. They were Jill and Lee were able to come and spend 4 days with us. I have a railing on the body back steps in the entryway. And I've got my garden ready, and some of it is planted.
Great.
And poor Jill, the kids will probably need treatment.
Jill and Lee came down to help Eleanor and George around the house, so they're very thankful for that visit as well. So, a lot of blessings today. I'm so glad to hear that. So, anything else? Yes, sir.
Grateful to start coming back to church, and grateful for meeting Hank and Tommy. I'm also grateful. My sister is expecting an August, and I'm grateful that she's healthy.
Great.
She's doing
well. Well, we're glad to hear. Noah is thankful for being here, and thankful for meeting Tommy and Marquita, and so we are so glad you guys are here. So, anything else? Yes.
I'm thankful for my kids just because they have put up an awful lot, and they still remember that Mom is not down there to pick up all the pieces when things start going south on them.
Lois is, again, thankful for her kids. We are, absolutely. Anything else? We had one mention in Sunday school that I think we should mention. Actually, two. Arlo Scari is his name. It's a friend of Merwin and Carol's. He's having some serious health issues. So if you'd be praying for him, sure, we appreciate that. And then Vicki Deck. He's having some heart issues, so if you want to be praying for Vicki as well. So, is there anything else?
I remember Alyssa's mom. She has some health problems.
It's okay. Juanita's granddaughter, Elizabeth's mom, is having some health problems as well, so be praying for her as well. Anything else?
I just
want
to say that I'm part of a lot of families in here. I'm related to a lot of people in town, and I'm just grateful for everybody.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of thankfulness and gratefulness going around today, so I'm glad that our hearts are joyous. Anything else? All right, will you pray with me? Lord God and Heavenly Father, we just come to you with overflowing hearts of joy today, it seems like, Lord. And I am blown away by what you do in our lives and how you provide for us, Lord. And not just monetarily or with stuff, Lord, but you give us blessings that are eternal. You give us blessings that are make life here easier, Lord, from our moms to our kids to friends. Lord, we're just people you've put in our lives that have just given us so much joy through the years and cared for us and looked out for us. So, Lord, we are thankful for that. Lord, we are thankful for rekindled relationships. We are thankful for you inviting us back to this place of worship, to where we can come together as family. Lord, we are just so thankful for what you do in our lives. Lord, we can go on and on about the blessings you give us. Lord, we just are so thankful for all of it. Lord, we pray that you would just be with those few prayer requests that we mentioned, Lord, with Arlo and with Elizabeth's mom, with Vicki. Lord, they're having some health issues, and we know that they're pretty serious. And so, Lord, we know that we can't decide the outcome. That's why we come to you and leave it up to you. Lord, we pray for your will to be done in their lives, that you might work and show them you through your goodness and greatness. Lord, we pray, Father, for this continued time that we have to worship. Lord, we just are so thankful for this place, these people that is the church, Lord, that we come together to worship you. Father, we just say thank you. It's in Jesus' precious and holy name that we pray. Amen.
Stand with us as we prepare our hearts for communion.
Think back to a mother, the mother of our Lord. His mother stayed near. Mary was there on Jesus' most difficult day. Now standing beside Jesus' cross were his mother, his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. John 19:25, as Jesus suffered, she experienced the full weight of Simeon's words. A sword will pierce your own soul. Luke 2:35, asked her son, spoke his first final words. Yet her mind raced back to his first word. Mary was as close to his last breath as she had been for his birth first. In spite of the pain, Mary stayed near. How could a mother endure? Jesus wants all of his followers to imitate his mother by staying near to him. Listen closely and never forgetting his agony. This is why he took the bread and said, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Luke 22:19. And the cup saying, "This cup is a new covenant."
which is poured out for you. 22:20, the loaf and the cup are Jesus' invitation to all the believers to come close, linger beside Jesus, cross just like his mother. Could we have done that? Could we have stood? Or would we have fallen on our knees? I think I would have. Would you pray with me? Father, we thank you so much for Jesus our Savior. We thank you for those who are with him, stayed with him, helped him through that agony. Let us be strong and stand by him at this table, remembering everything that happened. Help us, Father, to be the first and the last, to always be there, never to give up, never to leave. Father, as we partake of these emblems, each and every one of us here knows what happened. We know that he went through for us. Father, as we partake, I pray with all my being that we never forget. As his mother, that we remain faithful, even through all of that. That we can stay, say when we meet him, we stay there. We were there at the cross. As we partake communion, we never forgot you. Always remember what was given. Father, the love that was felt, the love that was given, the love that was shown, let us imitate that. Let us have that in our hearts for our Lord that we partake. Father, I thank you so much for this opportunity we can come to be near him, partake of his emblems, as he said. It's in your name. Amen.
Thank you.
say again, Happy Mother's Day, okay? And I want you to understand where I come from. And I hope today's message will give you kind of a peek into how I feel about moms, women in general, I guess so to say. And, you know, moms, you know, you're the ones who take care of all the women out there, you know, or to all the women who take care of the kids that are yours and not yours, right? I sure do appreciate those women in my life who stepped up in very special ways along my path, right? Most of you know that I lost my mom 2 years ago, right? And so I know what it is to not have a mom. And I want to tell you that if your mom is still with us and she's not here, call her, okay? Talk to her. Because I could go on all day long thanking moms for what they do. I want you ladies to know, whether you have kids or not, okay? God has gifted you with His divine nature to care over children, okay? You have. God has. And today's a special day. We come together to celebrate that. But not only celebrate that, we also want to honor God in heaven, right? We don't just come here to look at moms, but that's what we're going to do. But we want to come together as family and to look at God's word and see what He says about it. Can I tell you that the honor that we give God and to moms is a lifetime task? It's not something that we can just do one day a year, right? I think this is why it's so important for us to have God in our homes every day, not just once a week, right? God's to be a part of our life and our home life and our work life and our social life each and every day. Because if we reduce it down to 1 hour a week, we're not doing a very good job of honoring God. And the same goes with our moms, right? Our parents, but mostly our moms. You know, we'll talk about dad in a few weeks, but today is about moms, right? And to put together a Mother's Day message is always difficult, because if you've been anywhere around church or been through the Hallmark section at Target or Walmart or the Hallmark store, right? You can read just about every scripture about moms and thankfulness and gratefulness. If you've been to church long enough in your life, you've heard just about every sermon about moms there is to hear, right? So there's nothing that I can articulate well enough other than this. Ralph Waldo Emerson said it this way: men are what their mothers make them. Right? Mother's Day is when children try to give something back to their moms. For what? For all the extra spit they produce to wipe those faces off. Right? How about this one? It's a way for children to say thank you for when your mom says, spit out that gum, and she holds out her hand and you, right? And mom's like, gee, thanks, right? But all the noses wiped, all the scraped knees that were kissed, all the prayers that you prayed over them with unconditional, all the unconditional love you've given them when children were hard-headed and stubborn, right? This is the day mothers are rewarded for getting up in the middle of the night and washing those sheets, right? I don't know about you, but my kids have like loft beds. Boy, howdy, it's a fun night when they throw up in bed. Guess who ain't doing it? Mom does it, right? For all the things, all the driving, all the taxi trips that you do when the kid misses the buses or the sporting events or the sitting in the rain and the shine just to watch your kid perform, right? Getting sunburned, getting soaked to the bone, whatever it is. I would tell you that, Mom, you deserve a lot more than just one day a year. But to keep it on the lighter side of things, how many of you have ever heard of Calvin and Hobbes? I love Calvin and Hobbes because he's a lot like me, okay? But there was a cartoon a few years back where he gave his mom a handmade Mother's Day card. You might have heard it before, but he wrote a poem for her. And it was early in the morning. He comes jumping into her bedroom and jumps on her bed and presents her with a card. She opens it up and it reads this. I was going to buy a card with hearts of pink and red, but then I thought I'd rather spend the money on me instead. It's awfully hard to buy things when one's allowance is so small, so I guess you're pretty lucky I got you anything at all. Happy Mother's Day to you. There, I said it. Now I'm done. So how about getting out of bed and start cooking breakfast for your son? That's me to a T, by the way, just so you know. Thanks, Mom, for all you do, but it wouldn't make it, right? I really hope none of you moms get a card like that. But just in case you feel underappreciated, know that you are appreciated. I really hope that you understand that our appreciation as Christians comes from our love for God and the love that we have for you. And God actually wrote you a poem in the Bible about moms and hardworking women and different things. And it's found in Proverbs 31. And you've probably heard this message before 1,000 times, but maybe you haven't. But I want to share with you today the heart of God's message is to women in general. So let me pray and then we'll dig in. God, I just come to you. Thank you for this day. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you for those moms that you place in our lives that encourage us sometimes with a swift, hard kick in the butt. Lord, you give them the ability to care over and nurture us, and Lord, we thank you for them. And we pray that we would do more than just honor them one day a year, that we would try to honor them every day by the way we live. And Lord, that you've given them that nature, that we would honor you by what you've instilled in them, that they've instilled in us. Lord, thank you. May we live for you in all that we do. Father, it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you have your Bibles and you're there in chapter 31 of Proverbs, this chapter was written by a guy named King Lemuel. I can't really say his name, Lemuel. It actually says it right there. The sayings of King Lemuel. Right? And it tells you so. But if you look at verse 1, what does it tell you? It's the sayings of King Lemuel, an inspired utterance. Who taught him?
Mother.
His mother taught him. That is correct. And if this is included in God's word, we have to remember that all scripture is God-breathed, and it's useful for teaching, rebuking, and correcting, right? So this is God's very words to us through King Lemuel. And God wanted us to know how we are to look at our moms, and view our moms, and view women and ladies in general. And it's exciting to see that God writes this poem about it. And if you look there at verses 10 through 31, you understand that this is a 22-line poem dedicated to godly women and especially moms. Look at verses 28 and 29. Let's start there. We're going to be all over the place in this chapter. It says, "Her children arise and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all." How many of you moms would love to hear that from your husband and your children? Right? The last line of this inspired poem, and now it says, "Honor her with all that her hands have done, and let her works bring her praise at the city gate." Some translations put it this way: give her the reward she has earned. She should be praised in public for what she has done. I read a statistic the other day that we guys and children try to honor our moms with gifts, right? And the average that is spent on moms, how much do you think the average is?
Person? $20.
No, just the average spent on a mom. $20?
More.
$50.
$50?
$100. $5. $270. Surprised. Yeah, I was too. I was like, really? I used to get her like a 50-cent car. Man. So I think that's an overall of, like, if you have multiple children, right? I think it's an overall thing. But it didn't say, it just said the average the spend on mom in the United States was $270.
Is that for the year or for Mother's Day?
I think for Mother's Day. So, men, children, we got to get to work, right? Anyway, let's get back to it. Let's look at God's word here. So we want to understand that we want to praise the women and the moms for what they do in our lives. So the question comes up, what makes them so praiseworthy? Now, I know, just hang with me here, ladies, okay? But what makes you so praiseworthy is what the question that I thought of. The rest of Proverbs 31 offers what I kind of see as like three characteristics as to why, okay? And it's kind of, you know, that we have to understand that they've taken great care throughout all of this, all of our lives. So number one, I want you to understand that this is, I'm doing this for all women, okay? But you got to understand that there are things in Scripture that God designs, okay? And so let's look at it. So the first one that I believe is a valuable wife. It may seem counterintuitive, but the first quality of a praiseworthy mom has nothing actually to do with motherhood. It's rather King Lemuel begins with this. Look at verse 10. 10, 11, and 12. A wife of noble character who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. Now, I realize there are some single mothers out there that are raising their kids and paying their bills on their own. And I want God to be in that as well. But that's where we as a church, I think we ought to encourage those moms and help them out as much as we can. But I believe it's not the way God designed it for the home to be. He intended for parenting to be a team effort. I want you to understand that. He did. But I also know that there are women out there who are neither married or have kids. Okay? And this is what I was talking about at the beginning. God's divine nature to nurture is in you. Ladies, God's divine nature to do that is in you. One of the first commandments that God told Adam and Eve was to create children. Okay? So that divine nature to nurture is in all of you women. And I want to tell you that the many moms in my life haven't always been married or had kids. But they saw a bum of a kid hanging around the church, and they would take me under their wing, and they would offer their mothering. I call it love in the form of cookies, okay? And I want to tell you that I've seen some fantastic ministries in church that focus on kids from lots of fantastic women through the years. I have seen women give parents breaks, lunches bought, crazy lives made still for a moment. All by women who take the time to care for a mom, to take care like a mom. Okay? And I believe that this is one of the true blessings that I've got to see in ministry, seeing how much all of you love kids. How much you love kids. And in fact, in one of the blessings of my life is how much you love kids of ministers, right? It fills my heart with joy to see how you care for my kids like they're your own. And it's not always just my kids. It's all the kids here. But being in a unique position that I'm in, I've got to watch that. But I want you to see something here that he brings up about being a valuable wife, right? What does he say that she is? She's worth more than rubies. She's more valuable than anything that I can think of. It describes her relationship with her husband, and that relationship is built on something. It's built on trust. They're meeting each other's needs in all aspects. They help each other. They're working together as a team. And unfortunately, in this world, so many parents, their kids become their focus, right? It becomes an unhealthy pattern. Our kids become our life, right? Kids demand a lot of attention. We tie their shoes, we wipe their noses, they pack their lunches, we drive them to school, they take them to practice, and so on. And who does that responsibility fall on a lot? Mom. Our world begins and revolves around them when we center our weekends around our activities. And don't mention those nights when they get scared and they come and they jump in the middle of your bed between you guys, right? And on rare occasions when you and your husband do get a night out, what do you end up talking about?
Kids.
This kid-focused life isn't healthy for marriages. It turns out that it's not good for kids either. There's been some studies done on it. There's an author, his name's David Cody, wrote a book called To Raise Happy Kids, Put Your Marriage First. He says, these days, many parents seem to be married to their children instead of their spouses. This creates stressed out parents who feel disconnected from each other and demanding and entitled kids who act out. When parents are focused on their children, that they don't have time and energy to relate to their spouse. They're more quickly to grow disconnected. That disconnectedness, kids begin to pick up on it. And it leads to their insecurities and their anxieties. And when they are pouring all of their attention into children instead of their spouses, the kids start to feel like they're entitled and the world revolves around them. And they begin to have this behavioral issue go on in their lives. I can tell you, I've seen it many times firsthand. I've seen that throughout my ministry of 20 years, I've seen where families are staying together because of the kids, and then soon as the kids go off to college, what happens? I'm divorced. I've seen it many, many times. It's so true. So we have to understand that the one of the first qualities that we have to have as a mom is to be a valuable wife. The relationship between you and your husband comes first. The second thing I believe that we see here is that a mom or a woman is a vigorous worker, right? The next section lets us know that you're busy and hardworking and industrious woman. Look at verses 15 through 18. She gets up while it's still night. She provides food for her family and portions for her female servants. She considers a field and buys it. Out of her earnings, she plants a vineyard. She sets about her work vigorously. Her arms are strong for her tasks. She sees that her trading is profitable, but her lamp does not go out at night. You can continue to read and see that it goes on and on about the kind of work that moms do inside and outside the home. It might shock you that they actually do work outside the home. These verses describe a career woman. She is busy buying, selling, trading. She's described as a manufacturer, importer, manager, realtor, farmer, seamstress, upholsterer, and merchant. Right? And did you see that her lamp never goes out at night? That's an important verse to understand. That what King Lemuel was saying, what God through King Lemuel was saying, is that her work is never done. Yeah. Ladies, you work hard. You work incredibly hard. And I'm sure you've seen it before, but a mom's yearly salary to salary.com. You know how many different jobs a mom's mom has that they've been broke down to? 10. And then they deserve to be charging about $115,000 a year. Maybe with inflation, it's $130,000 a year now, right? It's crazy. Here, listen, here's the 10. Daycare worker, senior teacher, CEO, psychologist, cook, housekeeper, laundry machine operator, computer operator, facilities manager, janitor, and cab driver. 10 jobs that they kind of reduced them down to. And I can give you all the numbers, but man, it's crazy. Wild how much moms work. Let me tell you this. By the time a child reaches 18, a mother has had to handle some extra 18 hours. 18,000 hours of child-generated work. Did you hear that? 18,000 hours of child-generated work. That's crazy. That breaks down to about a 100-hour work week, doesn't it? Woo! I don't know about you, but and how many of you ladies get paid for being a mom? You get paid for being a mom?
I did.
Nah.
I got $100 a month.
Oh, I can say that.
You do it for free, right? Whether you're a stay-at-home mom or a mom that works outside the home, the work you do is priceless. The energy and the time that you pump into kids is priceless. I hope you understand that. It is priceless. I cannot tell you enough how much women in my life that have been cared for me and taken care of me, that I value that so much. So you have a valuable wife, a vigorous worker, and the third thing I think you get from this scripture is a virtuous woman. Look at verses 25 through 27. She is clothed with strength and dignity. She laughs at the days to come. She speaks with wisdom, and faithful instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. You see, this part about being a virtuous woman is about less about what you do and more about who you are. Did you catch all of that? She's strong and dignified. She doesn't get bent out of shape or worried about what tomorrow is going to throw at her. She enjoys life. She smiles. She laughs. She speaks with wisdom and kindness. She cares about her family. She's careful about how she spends her time. Earlier in verse 20, she shows compassion to the poor and needy. She even cares about others outside of her household. The question then becomes, where do these virtues come from? Where do these virtues come from? Can I tell you they're a result from her reverence for the Lord God? Remember that God created you ladies with his divine nature in you. He created you with this sense to the all these things that point back to him. In verse 30, look at that. It says, charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. We live in a society that places a lot of value on what a woman looks like, what her weight is, what her appearance is. We don't want to get old because we think we look ugly and disgusting. And you know, that's just simply not true. Those things don't last. We gain weight. We get old, right? Things fall apart sometimes. I want to tell you that ladies, your attractiveness comes from your relationship with the Lord. And I can attest to that. Sure, my wife is, I think she's the most beautiful woman on the planet, right? But I can tell you firsthand that is not what attracted me to her and her to me. It's because we love God. And we're trying to walk in that way. And I know what you're thinking. You're looking at me going, yeah, she's beautiful. You're dumb. I get it. I feel the same way. But it's about our relationship with the Lord. Ladies, your praiseworthiness comes from your relationship with the Lord, not anything else. A praiseworthy mom, a praiseworthy woman is to be Christ-like. And when you have a real, authentic walk with God, his character comes out in you. The love, the joy, the peace, the patience, the kindness, the goodness, the wisdom, the compassion, to pour into to people and mostly kids. And I know, listen, I'm closing up here. And I know that there are some of you moms out there, some of you ladies out there that don't feel at all like this. You think you look at this and go, kid, that's the ideal woman that God is talking about, right? And you might look at this and you might feel inferior. And it's not simply my intention. I hope you know that God, through King Lemuel, wanted you to know that he was inspired by his mother, his grandmother, and other women in his life. It's a composite picture of a good and godly woman or a mom. Everywhere. And can I tell you that you're more like her than you realize? It's not really a model for you to imitate in every detail, though. You got to make it your own. Let it be an inspiration to you that God made you to be you. That God made you to be what it is, and he put his divine nature in you to let your gifts shine. You got to let your life shine, not this one. And I promise you that God will do the rest, and he'll take care of you. And you must always remember that charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised, and we want to praise you women today. This day and on, not just one day a year, we want to pour into you and let you be what you can be. And I would not be where I am today if it were not for godly women pouring into my life. I have several. Most of them are not with me anymore. Actually, I don't have any of them anymore. But I want you to know that you ladies have a special, special job inside the church and for God. There are so many kids out there that are hurting, that are lost, that need a woman to take them under their arms. Fear the Lord. You are to be praised. Will you pray with me? God, I just come to you to say thank you. Lord, I cannot express enough thanks for what you've done in my life. Through the women that you've placed in my life that have treated me as their son. Lord, I pray that you would just be with us out there as we, if we still have our moms with us, Lord, I pray that we would think about them today and praise them. Lord, I am thankful to see all the women that pour into kids. I give up their time, of their effort, of their energy, of their money, of their love, or whatever it is that they care about kids. And Lord, I just pray that you would be with them, protect them, and bless them. Lord, we thank you for your word that you show us, that you show us through your inspired word of what it is, a model to look to, Lord, that we can turn to you in everything. Father, I thank you so much for it. I thank you for those women that are displaying Christ in our lives and showing us what it is to be a true servant. Lord, we love you. It's in Jesus' precious and holy name that we pray. Amen. I want to end there today, and I want you guys to know that you are loved. Moms, you are loved and you are appreciated more than just one day a year. And as a token, just grab a cookie here. There's cookies back there. Please feel appreciated today and go and love on your moms. And have a great day. Go and love God and love others. Have a great week, everyone.
Like 20 minutes.
You got a million bushes.
Thank you.
Have a great week, Bill.
What's that?
Have a great week.
Well, you too.
He's the second.
And he got the bunch of, yes. Three. No.
too.
No, it's his younger brother. He's the one who's in the military now.
Here's with the younger boy.
And then Simon.
He's older. Yeah. Simon.
There's an older brother.
I'm trying to go through all the names in my head.
I never. No.
No, I don't think so.
So you got an older brother, you know what? Then you got Peter and Scarlett.
Scarlett and Simon.
He worked as a girl. He has a. He graduated.
That's right.
So, yeah.
He just got home. He was gone with Kim. They got home a little bit ago.
It's kind of cool. Yeah, so that's probably how he got signed up with Tommy and because. Because you worked in the basement too. I think so.
I know, like,
I guess I don't know.
She stepped over right
in time.
Yeah.
I did,
yeah.
Okay.
How are you doing, man?
I'm good, how are you?
Off-ground.
Congratulations, graduated parents. Again.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see you over there. Did you?
Oh, I snuck in.
You snuck in. Okay, well, you did a good job.
Thank
you.
Right.
What do you got? Something for her mom.